So, Timothy.
De La Ghetto.
What are we talking about?
What do you think is the secret to a long-lasting relationship?
Tim's still trying to figure that shit out.
Well, first of all, how long have you been with Chia?
Let's see, it is 2020. So in September, it will be 9 years.
What?
What?
Whoa! I felt like you guys have been together for four.
Wait, 9 years?
Wow.
Well, that's the thing too. I feel like if we want to talk about the development of a relationship, right? Like time-wise, yeah, it's been 9 years. But I also would tell people, because even back then, a year is us only seeing each other a week out of every month, mm-hmm. you know? So I almost feel like a year is really like 4 months, or three yeah. months. If you want to look at it like in terms of time
getting
that we
yeah.
get to know each other and FaceTime and shit like that. But technically it's a 9 year relationship because we got together officially in 2011. Yeah, so it's been 9 years. Yeah.
Wow. So then now how long has it been since you guys been living together?
Living together for since we got married, so about a year and a half. Mm.
Mm-hmm. So what would you say is the secret to continue this relationship in the years to come?
I think, you know, it sounds cliche, but it's facts. I think communication is the biggest thing in a relationship. You just gotta, you know, be real with each other.
What's that?
Just being vulnerable and open.
Yeah, just communicate your feelings. Talk about, you know, what's on your mind. Like, don't expect the other person to know what you're thinking or feeling.
What if you go, that cheese smells bad? Is that being vulnerable?
Nope.
Well,
it's opening up.
Let's say you've been arguing about fucking the refrigerator smells like shit because you don't clean shit, and someone has to be like, well, the cheese smells bad, the cheese that you bought, bitch!
That's communication.
No, because sometimes I'll, because I'm still trying to learn too, right? So sometimes, like, I'll say something to her, like, I don't know, something maybe like, oh man, I'm so sad I missed biceps today. I didn't have enough time. And she's like, what? I don't care. I'm like, babe, I was trying to be vulnerable with you. And she's like, that's not being vulnerable.
It's not interesting. You missed biceps today. That's all you got?
Yeah, that's how he wants our relationship to get stronger. He's like, but I'm being vulnerable with you. Do you love me?
But don't
that's
you
how I love you.
Those his biceps are like something he cares about.
I don't
about
give a
life.
Fuck, Tim.
How do you talk about it though? I'm trying to help. I'm trying to help, right?
Yeah,
how
yeah,
do
yeah.
I
talk?
Oh, about I'm biceps. Sorry, your biceps. Let's.
Or sometimes I have the best. I realize like I have something really interesting to talk about.
Okay.
But it's when she's taking a shit. And then, so I'm standing there trying to have a conversation.
Right.
And she's like, get away from me.
Yeah. But he opens the door.
But I'm gonna lose my inspiration.
He's me and he's like this. He's like. Talking to me, I'm like, what the fuck? Let me shit, please.
But then now I lose.
You're like jail homies.
Yeah.
He's like, hey, I just had this really cool thought. He's like, yeah, so I missed calves today, and I know we were talking about it
yeah.
earlier.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then Gio's like, yeah.
I don't have to push that hard.
Okay. Yeah.
Hey, man. We can talk about it
this time. Like, yeah. And what else?
Just text me.
That's funny. How about you guys? Because you guys have been together for a long time, so what's the secret?
I'm still trying to figure out from you guys.
What we've been trying to implement more of is having a specific day for us, because that's been pretty good. Like, because we can get lost in like work and just like kid time or whatever. So just like designating, like this will be our date day. That's always cute.
That's good.
Yeah, because we realize family time isn't the same as also like romance, marriage time.
Yeah.
Because then our dynamic is different when the kid's around too.
Yeah, for real. You gotta make sure you that is a priority. Yeah, for sure.
How about being boring with one another?
Boring.
What about it?
Yeah, do you guys ever make time to be boring together?
I don't know what that means.
Yeah, it means like.
Oh, you mean not necessarily a date, just chilling.
Just chilling. Like I'm fucking bored and you're bored and we're bored together and we're just like chilling, watching TV or whatever it is.
Yeah,
it doesn't
we'll
have to
that.
Be exciting.
Yeah, we'll consider that a date. Like, but it has to be intentional where it's like it's us time. Like there's no grandma or there's no friends or there's no Taika or whatever. Even if it's just us going to a park and like sitting in a car.
Because if we're, I guess being bored together, but if it's intentional, I think that's good. But if it's like, she unintentionally went on her phone, I unintentionally on my phone, we're in two different worlds. Technically, we're in the same space, but we're not really bonding or being
together.
Yeah,
we're not present.
So, Mark Manson, the author of The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck.
He's dope. I interviewed him on my podcast.
Yeah, you did have him on your podcast.
Oh, that's cool.
So, he says this. I think if you look at a relationship, I actually think it should be as boring as possible. And that sounds really weird to people, but if you think about it, a really happy 80-year-old couple that's been together for 60 years, the reason that they've been together for 60 years isn't because they took all these private jets and they had all these crazy vacations and, oh my God, look at their pictures. It's because they were able to be boring together. They are able to spend year after year sitting around the house, talking about the same boring stuff, watching TV, watching movies, cooking dinner, and it went fine. There was nothing exciting, nothing that... There's nothing blowing up. There's no huge drama and dishes flying.
I love that.
So, I love that.
That's my marriage, period. Yeah. And then when we go somewhere cool, it's even better.
Yeah, I think that's cool because a lot of people, they're trying to chase novelty or a certain feeling, and it's a drug that never ends. But if you're happy with just their presence and the conversation, I think that's the biggest foundation of a relationship.
Yeah. Dude, for sure. And that spoke to me really loudly because my love language is quality time. So that is like... Let's just fucking sit and just be together and like communicate, like talk about our days. Like that's fucking boring, but let's do that.
Do you want Casey to talk about his biceps?
No. Sure. If, I mean, if that's what he cared about, then tell me all about your biceps.
Casey's a tricep guy.
I couldn't do my biceps.
So me and Nikki, we've been fucking up the show Bachelor. We've been watching it and just laughing our asses off and shit like that. It's just so much fun. It's like, let's order Thai food and let's watch The Bachelor or let's watch fucking Love Island and make fun of everyone.
That's fucking awesome. Yeah.
So fun. It's like more fun than anything I can think of.
No, I agree. Especially, well, so when we went on the honeymoon to the Maldives, right? Everybody was like, some people were like, you know what? It's pretty and all, but you guys will get bored. There's really nothing to do but just like look at the ocean and eat.
But it ain't where you're at. It's who you with, baby. Bro,
and we were like, yo, that's perfect. You know what I'm saying? Because all we wanted to do was just fucking chill.
Yes.
And that's what we did.
Did you say fucking chill or fuck and chill?
Bars. Both. But like literally there was like mad days where we were just there either just like just looking at the ocean. Just in bed on our laptops, you know what I'm saying? Just hanging out, or she would be out there tanning, and I would just be like next to her, just on my phone, just relaxing, and that was it. Like we had such a good time, just being bored together, man.
Yeah, being bored with yourself, because I got to do that when I went on my trip. I'm like, this is gorgeous. There's nothing to do but just look at fucking paradise, and I'm bored, but I'm content.
Yeah.
But yeah, so I don't know. I thought that was kind of cool what Mark Manson was talking about, because. Yeah, I mean, a lot of people these days, especially with social media, everyone sees everyone on social media and they're like, oh my God, we gotta take these expensive trips, we have to do this, we have to do that, and this is how we'll get happy, and that's not the case. So,
you're
just setting up expectations for yourself you can't even meet.
I feel like being bored is just like a young people thing, too. It's like, when you get older and you have time to yourself, you're not bored, you love it.
Yeah, you're like, I could finally be with myself or in control of like what I want my time to be like. There's so many other stimuli or whatever happening around that you're like, fuck, I gotta tend to all these other things.
Yeah.
The other thing is allowing your partner to be themselves around you is really important. Not feeling like they're uncomfortable to do, they have to do something else. They can't just do what they would be doing if they were alone right now, like that kind of shit. Mm-hmm. Like helping to facilitate that kind of environment is so fucking important. It makes people feel like when you're home, like they're home too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And not like, oh, I can't wait for my husband to leave so I can be myself or my wife to leave so I can be myself. It's like, I'm already myself when they're home.
And what if you being yourself tramples the other person's self?
Right. Then I think you have a destructive personality.
So you also got to be kind of conscious of how you are while you're being yourself.
Well, being yourself is not hurting others. Like if that is something that you are doing, you should go to therapy.
Yeah, for sure.
That's true.
And for sure, you know, you got to find a balance too when you start living together. Like, you know, I had to learn certain things about Chia. Like, I remember one day I woke up just singing, you know what I'm saying? I was so happy, I was singing and shit. But she's not a morning person until she has her coffee and her breakfast. So
that's her too.
Yeah, so I woke up and I'm like fucking like happy and singing and shit. She's like, babe, not yet. She's like, can I just let me have my coffee and I'll be good. And I was like, oh, at first I was like, excuse me, I'm fucking, I'm bouncing because I'm so happy, you know? Yeah. I was like, so you want me to tone my happiness down right now for you? I was like, you want me to fucking, like, I was like, but I had to get used to that, you know?
That's when I text my other wife. I'm like, I'll text my other
you
wife.
You married another woman? You're dumb.
You can be such a dick, though, too, because it's like, because of her circumstances, you're like, oh, I'm sorry, I know you have to get your coffee so you can go to your job.
So you can poo.
Yeah, whatever that is.
Single work.
She has to get ready to get to the couch.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, excuse me, you need to wake up to do nothing.
Wow.
I don't know if bored is the right word for this, because what it sounds like to me is it's more like a calmness and a relaxed feeling, because boredom, I think you equate that with missing out, or you're actually anxious because you're not feeling relaxed in the situation.
Yeah.
Yeah, when you say you're being bored, I think it's like, I need stimulation. But if you're with someone that you enjoy the company of, that's enough stimulation. You could be doing boring things.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
That's like saying I'm content with that person.
Yeah. And if you're with somebody who can help you be yourself, then
it's even better.
Even better.
Because you feel good about just existing.
Yeah. Like Nikki was going through some shit recently, and she told me that no matter what, she knew that, like, she always has me. So she, it's like no matter what. At the end of every day, if everything in my life blows up, I have Steve. And that's how I feel about her. So that's the money, man.
And you shouldn't feel like the first person you have to walk on eggshells around is your significant other.
Exactly.
Because that's torture.
That's torture. Yeah. It's scary. And then your significant other is something that is dragging you down.
Right.
Yeah, so who's your safe spot? Yeah. Like, where's your safe haven?
Yep.
Right. But that's where I think the word boredom might be taken out of context, where people might be like, oh, I don't want to be. If you're really bored with the person, that's not good either.
I guess it just depends on how you define boredom for yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah, like I guess what we're talking about here, how you redefined it.
Yeah.
It's just like, the message is the same.
It's at peace.
Yeah.
Being at peace.
For the sake of this, he's flipping bored just because you equate boredom with doing nothing.
Yeah.
But really, boring is feeling like, when you're not doing anything, you feel like, fuck, I need to be doing something. But like when you're not doing anything and you're like, oh, I'm satisfied, then you're not bored anymore. You're just at peace.
Yeah, I think it's trying to make a point where the relationship these days, based off social media, they're trying to do the least boring things. And I think he's saying like, you can search for love and happiness in boring places.
Yeah. Oh dude, I see people all over Instagram projecting how tight the relationship is. Like it's that shit.
Yeah. Every single post is, we're having a blast, this is the best fucking loving relationship in the whole entire world.
And I'm like, I've seen the inside of this machine. It's scary in there, dude.